Hey, so I've been thinking about music lyric videos and how I'm not really much of an animator myself, so I wanted to find a DIY approach to creating them with tools that you already have access to and can save you a lot of precious time. All of which is going to come together and create something like this. If you like what you see and you're interested, then please do give this video a like and subscribe if you're not already. But without further ado, let's get into today's video. So in preparation, you're going to need a pen or paint, a sheet of paper, ideally the biggest that you can find, a camera, and in this case, I actually ended up using my iPhone. And of course, it wouldn't be a music video if it didn't have a music track. We of course used artlist.io, as we know that all the tracks are royalty free. We found an amazing song by a band called WEARETHEGOOD. This is what we're gonna be doing our lyrics to. Oh my, oh my. And what's even better is that Artlist even provides the lyrics so we can give it a once over and make sure that we're writing down the right thing. And of course, a free copy of HitFilm to do your editing. That's it, that's everything you need. What you're first gonna do is write out your lyrics or dialogue on the sheet of paper. Use bold, thick strokes to make sure that everything is clear as possible. Whiteboard pens or chunky biro pens are perfect for this. Leave large gaps in between the lines of dialogue so you can float between them later. Now's the time to throw in your earbuds and play the song or dialogue. Film along to feel the rhythm and get your timing right. Add in some creative camera movement to really emphasize some of these lyrics. I ended up filming mine line by line just to give everything the proper attention it needed. So after filming all your lyrics, we're going to come into HitFilm. I've already got my project set up and the shots I want in the place that I feel like they're most fitted. However, the first thing that you're gonna notice is that we have far too much and we can't see the footage behind that I wanna use for the music video. So the first step is gonna be masking the area that I want to keep. I'll go up to the pen tool and then just mask around the area. Now, it doesn't have to be anything too crazy. It's just going to be a rough mask that you can use. Now, I did lie a little bit. We are going to use a couple of keyframes to make sure that our mask sticks around only the text layer. So what I'm going to do for this is go into the controls panel, go into mask, and under transform, I will add a keyframe by the path. And then as it kind of like goes through, I will just drag some of these over the area and let it kind of like animate over. Cool. There's nothing in this area, so I'll drag it all the way down. Now we're cropping some out, so I'll grab it back. And this doesn't have to be clean. It is just, like I said, it's a garbage mat. It's kind of just a rough idea of the area itself. Cut off the S there, so. And then, yeah, cool, bring that back up. Nice, so that's the first step, doing a rough mask around the area and the text that you wanna keep. You'll then have to repeat this throughout the video to make sure that you're getting the right areas that you wanna keep. And yeah, once you've gone through your timeline and you have all the lyrics cut out and masked, it's now time to apply a couple of effects and then we have our final thing. The first effect that we're going to use is called a luminance key. What a luminance key does is eliminate either the highlights or shadows of an image. So as you can see right now, it's actually removed the dark text of our image. But if we go into the key type and change it to key out the brighter, now all we have is just our text. Because I want my text to be in a shade of white, I'm actually going to apply a invert and drag that on, cool, and immediately it's turned into white. Now, as you can see, there is kind of like a rough outline on most of our text, and I kind of want to remove some of that. So the last thing that we'll add is a matte cleaner, throw that on, and all we're gonna do is just choke in a little bit of those details, just so we have enough to, you know, sort out that little bleed. This is looking good, and I feel like what we could do is maybe add a little bit of a wobble to our edges. So I'm gonna use a edge distortion for this. Now, edge distortion is only available in HitFilm Pro right now, but you can download the demo, try it out for yourself, and see what you think. This is just an added flourish. You don't need this to create the effect, okay? And I'll just change the preset to something like a small wobble. Maybe that's a little bit too intense. Maybe subtle line wiggle. All that's gonna do is just distort the image a little bit. Just to bring out the image a little bit more, I will apply a drop shadow. and just throw that on that. That's pretty okay. I might change the direction just ever so slightly, just so it's underneath, and then just soften it ever so slightly, just so it's there. Now, this is all gonna come down to the type of footage that you are gonna be using, but changing the blend mode is definitely gonna help it. Going for something like a soft light may be a little bit too much, but definitely an exclusion, or maybe an overlay blend mode would be better fitting for you. Times like this that you need to experiment with the type of footage that you're using and find a style that is really working for you. Now, to save myself a bit of time, what we can do is then grab all of these effects, right click, and then create a preset. Give it an appropriate name, save it, and down the bottom of our effects window under presets, we can now find this effect and drag that onto any other lyric that we have. The only thing that we need to change is going into the blend mode and setting the appropriate blend type. Something else that I found in shots like this where it's a little bit darker is to duplicate the lyric layer and then set that to a different blend type. For example, if I take this one and hold Control, drag it underneath to create a copy, now you can see it's already brighter, but maybe a little bit too bright. But if I go into the blend mode and set this to screen and then dial down the opacity, you can see that it's kind of like highlighted in different areas now. Or maybe go into soft light and then dial it back up, just to help bring things out a little bit more. Repeat this for every lyric of the music video and you're done. I had such a good time making this effect and it was highly requested by you guys. So if there is something else that you want to see in the future, then leave us a comment down below and we'll be sure to get around to it. But if you want to know how to do it from an animation standpoint, then let us know in the comment section down below and we'll be sure to work on a tutorial. We wanted to give you guys a really simple, easy way to do this so anyone can do it. I really do hope that if you've just begun your journey in content creation, that this is something that you're able to go out and create easily. If you have found this tutorial helpful, then please do consider liking and subscribing to the channel. It really does help us out and lets us know that you want more of this sort of video. Right, cool. I'm gonna go listen to that song another 7 times.